In this video, I'm going to demonstrate reading input from the user, mathematical calculations, and displaying output, including formatting numeric output to a specific number of decimal places. I'll create a program that computes the payment amount and total cost of borrowing for a loan to demonstrate these concepts. Before I can write a program to solve this problem, I need to know how to compute the payment amount and total cost of borrowing. Using Google, I located two formulas. The first computes the payment amount for a loan, while the second computes the total cost of borrowing. The first formula requires that the interest rate be expressed per payment period rather than as an annual rate. It also requires that the rate be expressed as a raw number rather than as a percentage. This means that if the user enters an annual rate of 5%, then our variable needs to contain 0.05 divided by the number of payments per year. In this program, I'll assume that we are making monthly payments, so the rate will be divided by 12. Our program will begin by reading the amount of money to be borrowed, the annual interest rate as a percentage, and the duration in years. The amount and the interest rate will be read as floating point numbers. I'll read the duration as an integer, making the assumption that the loans will always be for some number of complete years. Each of the values is stored in its own variable, and I have included an appropriate prompt as part of each input statement. Before I can use the formulas that I found with Google, I need to compute the interest rate per payment period as a raw number and the number of payments. I'll use additional assignment statements to create variables to hold each of these values. My program now includes variables that contain all of the values that I need to use the first formula. Python respects the usual rules for order of operations, so I will need to include parentheses around the expression in the denominator of the fraction to force Python to perform the division after it has performed the subtraction. Exponentiation is performed using the double asterisk operator. Now I can compute the total cost of borrowing for the loan using the payment amount calculated on the previous line. The results will be displayed using print statements. Running our program allows us to enter values for the loan amount, interest rate, and duration. Examining the output reveals that the results are reasonable, but the formatting leaves a lot to be desired. Since the values that are being displayed represent money, they should really be displayed with two decimal places. We also want the dollar sign to appear right next to the digits when the amount is printed. Python provides several mechanisms for formatting numbers to a specific number of decimal places. We'll demonstrate two of them in this program. One option is to use the built-in format function. When the format function is called, it requires two arguments, which are the value you want to format and a format specifier that describes how you want it formatted. In this case, the value that we want to format is whatever is stored in the payment amount variable. The format specifier is a string. The F at the end of it indicates that we are formatting a floating point number. The .2 before the F indicates that the number should be formatted so that there are two digits to the right of the decimal point. Including a comma at the beginning of the format specifier tells Python to use a comma as a digit group separator when displaying large numbers. We will also concatenate the formatted number to the previous string instead of passing it as a separate argument to the print function to prevent Python from including a space between the dollar sign and the formatted number. Another option for formatting output is to use the string formatting operator, which is represented by a percent sign. In this case, the format specifier is included in the same string as the message describing the output. The format specifier begins with a percent sign, it's followed by .2 to indicate that there should be two decimal places, and an F to indicate that we are formatting a floating point number. This style of formatting does not support a digit group separator. The string containing the format specifier is followed by the string formatting operator and the value that will be formatted. Running our program again demonstrates that both of these formatting techniques display a number rounded to two decimal places. You can use either of these techniques to format your output when writing programs in the future. This program has demonstrated reading input, mathematical calculations, and displaying output, including formatting numeric output. I hope that watching this video has increased your understanding of these topics.